And our word for today on this Thursday of the 11th week in Ordinary Time, this Thursday, June the 20th, our word for today is Father. Father is our word for today, and here to talk about it, Andrew Reinhart. Good morning, Andrew.
Good morning, Dave and Ron. How are you?
Great.
Doing great. How are you, Andrew?
Doing great. Doing great. Our word for the day is Father. And I want to start out, like you referred to the first reading earlier, Dave. I want to start out in the first reading here, too, because there's a reference, a subtle reference to fatherhood in this reading from Sirach. So in this reading, it's talking about the ministry of Elijah and Elisha over the people. And here it says, it kind of in the transition between the two, it says, then Elisha, filled with the twofold portion of his spirit, wrought many marvels by his mere word. Elisha, filled with the twofold portion of his spirit, wrought many marvels by his mere word. In this twofold portion, in the Hebrew context, this refers to the law around inheritance. So the son that was going to take on the household or the property of the father would gain a twofold portion, you know, not because he needed more money or something, but because since he had the care, the responsibility, the stewardship for the whole household, you know, the extended family, whatever servants, the flocks, the land, whatever, he received a twofold portion because of that stewardship. So in this reading, this kind of transition between Elijah and Elisha, there's something specific being said here that Elijah and Elisha weren't just powerful prophets, but they had a kind of stewardship, a kind of care, a kind of love for the whole people, right? Their prophetic word wasn't something that they, you know, just sort of showed up and said their word and did their great deeds and then left. No, there was a real sense that God had given them responsibility. God had given them a care for his people. So now fast forward to the first reading, or the gospel, and in this, Jesus is talking about prayer to the Father. And he says, do not babble like the pagans. And I always thought it was really interesting that they used that word babble there, right? Because there's a lot of words a translator or editor could use to just signify the fact that you shouldn't use too many words or use empty words or, you know, whether it would be being too loquacious or maybe wordy or chatty or talkative or what have you. But that word babble, when I hear it, I think of the Tower of Babel, right? This ancient tower where the people were building a tower in order to be like God, to reach God. What's interesting is a lot of, you know, archaeologists, a lot of historical critical commentators can't help but think of this tower in light of the ancient ziggurat, which was a common structure at the center of a Babylonian city or the civilization which Abram would have come out of. Right. And then, so they would have built this tower, a tower to a god. But what's interesting is their relationship, their idea of their god was much different than the Christian idea or the Hebrew idea. Because in these pagan sects, the idea is basically you make sacrifices, you do something for God, and then God does something for you. Right? It's a relationship of exchange. It's a relationship of power, right? I give you power over me, but then you give me power over others. You give me power over nature. You give me control. You give me security. And the foundational relationship that we as spiritual Semites, as inheritors of the Jewish faith and of this new covenant of the Lord, we're invited into a foundationally different relationship with our deity, one of fatherhood and sonship, one of childhood, one of being part of a family. Not a contractual relationship of exchange, of power, but a relationship of love and stewardship. So now let's connect this with our first reading. Right? Elisha receives the double portion in order to be steward over the land. Not power for power's sake, not power for Elisha's sake, power for the sake of the people. And notice in the Our Father prayer itself, we're asking for not what we want, but what God wants, right? We're not asking for specific things. We're asking for God's will. We're asking just to be sustained, to be taken care of. You know, it's a family prayer. It's a relational prayer. It's not a prayer to increase the size of our armies or to make it rain or to protect our borders or to raise up a great king. No, it's calling out to a father for what? For his kingdom, for his will, for his bread, for his forgiveness. Right? This is all familial. This is all relational. And so this is meant to form us in our thoughts, in our world, and how we interact with one another. So we're given a portion of God's kingdom, the kingdom of God, and we have stewardship over the world as a Christian. So this means the portion that God gives us, the portion of grace, the portion of our ability, our talents, the portion of the gifts and fruits of the Holy Spirit, the charisms for building up of the kingdom, these aren't for our power, for our glory, but they're for the care of others. They're for the care of the world and the care of the church. And we're called to labor like Elijah and Elisha did against the false prophets of their day, presenting the world with a different image, a different foundational image, not one of power and control and fear, but one of love and family and relationship. So our word for the day is Father.
Mm. And Andrew, the meaning, the original meaning of these words are important, right? And they bring such a different understanding. Look, twofold portion, until you just explained that, I never thought of it in that way. So it's so important to go back to the original language to gain the true understanding of what's being said.
Amen, amen. And knowledge of the law especially, you know, because these people that Jesus was preaching to and teaching, they were saturated in the law. So if you're ignorant of God's law to the Hebrew people, you'll never fully understand what Jesus is saying to those same people, you know, in his own time.
Mm. Love it.
Thank you, Andrew. Thank you so much, Andrew.
Wow. And have a great day. And we hope to join you tomorrow morning for the Friday morning offering. Don't forget to set your alarm watch here. 4:51 this afternoon. That's when summer officially arrives. Just so you know. Thanks for joining us.